Welcome to Gallant IAS. I'm Kimina. I'm your science and tech faculty. There is a saying, the science of today is the technology of tomorrow. Science and technology is one of the most dynamic topics in UPSC exam for both prelims and mains. Now, the questions are exclusively based on current affairs. The easiest way to prepare this part is to have an idea about the static portion with current development with respect to all domains of science and technology. In order to do that, first, we need to understand the syllabus. Second, we have to solve the previous year questions. Let's go through the syllabus. According to UPSC prelim syllabus, it's given as general science. It means we need a basic knowledge about physics, chemistry, and biology. But it is more oriented to current affairs. Prelims questions of science and technology have been asked from main syllabus. So, we need an integrated approach towards this topic. And in case of main syllabus, in GS3, development and everyday application and effects in everyday life, awareness in field of IT, space, computers, robotics, biotechnology and issues relating IPR, that is intellectual property right, achievements of Indians in science and technology, this is a static portion, and indigenization of technology and developing new technology. If you come across any news in the field of science and technology, please note these keywords from your main syllabus, that is new development of science and technology, applications of these new developments, achievements of Indians in the field of science and technology, indigenization and awareness in the field of science and technology. Then you can easily find out the types of questions and current affairs asked in exam. And let's see how science and technology is important from prelims and mains point of view. Considering the years 2011 to 19, on an average, 6 questions have been asked from prelims. And in case of mains, from GS paper 3, from the year 2013 to 19, on an average, 2 to 3 questions have been asked. Similarly, in essay paper also, topics of science and technology have been asked. Today, we are going to solve some of the prelims questions from the year 2019. Last year, around 8 questions have been asked in prelims. 4 from computer and modern physics, 3 from biotechnology and 1 from space topic. Let's solve the problems. First question, with reference to communication technologies, what is or are the difference or differences between LTE, long-term evolution, and VoLTE, voice over long-term evolution? First statement, LTE is commonly marketed at 3G and VoLTE is commonly marketed as advanced 3G. Second, LTE is data only technology and VoLTE is voice only technology. Select the correct answer using the code given below. Option A, one only. Option B, two only. Option C, both one and two. Option D, neither one nor two. This is a current affair question. To solve this question, we have to understand the term VoLTE. VoLTE allows an operator to offer both data and voice over 4G LTE network. The biggest advantage of Volt is that the call quality is superior to 2G and 3G connections, as much as more data can be transferred in 4G. From this, we can infer that the first statement, that is, LTE is commonly marketed at 3G and Volt is commonly marketed as advanced 3G. We know that Volt is associated with 4G, so the first statement is wrong. Then we can eliminate option A and option C. Moving on to the second statement, LTE is data only technology and Volt is voice only technology. We know that Volt is used both data and voice, so option B is wrong, that is the second statement is wrong. From this we can reach that option D is the right answer, that is neither one nor two. Second question. In the context of digital technologies for entertainment, consider the following statements. First statement, in augmented reality, that is AR, a simulated environment is created and the physical world is completely shut out. Second, in virtual reality, VR, images generated from the computers are projected onto real-life objects or surroundings. Third statement, AR allows the individual to be present in the world and improves the experience using camera of smartphone or PC. Fourth statement, VR closes the world and transposes an individual, providing complete immersion experience. Which of the statement given above is or are correct? Option A, 1 and 2 only. Option B, 3 and 4. Option C, 1, 2 and 3. Option D, 4 only. This is a current affair question like first question. Here we need to understand the two terms, that is augmented reality and virtual reality. In virtual reality, it is a computer generated simulation of real life environment which is primarily achieved through the use of headset. When worn, the user's vision and hearing aid is stimulated to provide a realistic experience. Second is augmented reality. Augmented reality is a superimposition of computer-generated images on an existing environment, which makes them more interactive. It utilizes in the form of applications in mobile devices such as Pokemon Go app, Disney coloring book. From this, we can infer that the second statement, that is virtual reality images generated from the computers are projected onto real life objects or surrounding, is wrong. If the second statement is wrong, we can eliminate option A and option C. Based on the same sentence, we can get the third statement, that is AR allows the individual to be present in the world and improves the experience using camera of smartphone or PC. So third statement is right, means we can get the answer as option B, that is 3 and 4 is the right answer. Fourth means virtual reality closes the world and transposes an individual, providing complete immersion experience. Moving on to the third question, consider the following statements about a digital signature. First statement, an electronic record that identifies the certifying authority issuing it. Second, used to serve as a proof of identity of an individual to access information of server on internet. Third, an electronic method of signing an electronic document and ensuring that the original content is unchanged. Which of the statement given above is or are correct? Option A, 1 only. Option B, 2 and 3 only. Option C, 3 only. Option D, 1, 2 and 3. This question is discussing about digital signature. per corporate affairs ministry's website, digital signature means electronic signature. Which is used to authenticate the identity of a sender of a message or signer of an electronic document. It ensures that the original content of the document is not changed. From this, we can get the third statement, that is an electronic document of signing an electronic document and ensuring that the original content is unchanged. That is option C is the right answer, because the first one and two statements are explaining about digital signature certificate. It is a separated mechanism, so option C is the right answer. Last question. In the context of wearable technology, which of the following tasks is or are accomplished by wearable devices? First, location identification of a person. Second, sleep monitoring of a person. Third, assessing the hearing impaired person. Select the correct answer using the code given below. Option A, 1 only. Option B, 2 and 3 only. Option C, 3 only. Option D, 1, 2 and 3. This question can be solved in two ways. First, I will explain in easy method. Have you heard about wearable devices? Smartwatch is a wearable device. Using it, we can track a person's GPS location, monitor heart rate, even sleeping pattern also. From this, we can get the answer. That is, the first one and two options are right. Location identification of a person. Second, sleeping monitoring of a person. The answer is D. 1, 2 and 3. Because there is only one option gives both one and two statement together. This is an easy method. Second method, just cross check the third statement, that is assisting the hearing impaired person. This is a current affair news. Have you heard about Linux 3D? It's a hearing aid product by ReSound company named as Honori, and which is categorized as both accessible tech and wearable tech by Consumer Electronics Show in Las Vegas. So the third statement is also right. Then we can get the answer. Option D. So right, 1, 2 and 3. Without knowing the current affair also, we can solve this problem. That's all for today. Thank you.